Hello, everybody.
Hi, Patti.
Happy Earth Day.
Happy Earth Day.
That's great. Thank you. Hello, I'm sorry. Hello, everyone. Happy Earth Day. Very grateful to be invited again this year and to be able to join everyone in this beautiful garden. I love this garden because it's, for me, twofold. With the sculpture, it represents the mind and the creativity of the human being, and of course, nature all around, the creativity and work of Mother Nature. So I wonder what they're looking for. First, we'd like to do a little song. It would be nice if they were up there holding a light of this garden for us, wouldn't it? But I have a feeling that's not what they're doing. We are very grateful to be here together and for another year, and I hope decades, centuries to come. So this little song is called Grateful. Another skin simply slips away. You can rise above it. It was shed easily. It all will come out fine. I've learned it line by line. One common wire, one silver thread, all that you desire rolls on ahead. Like a ship in a bottle, held up to the sun, sails ain't going nowhere. You can count everyone until it crashes unto the earth, simply slips away. You can hide in the open. I just disappear. It all will come out fine. I've learned it line by line. One common wire, one silver thread, all that you desire rolls on ahead. Tenderness, die, little sparrow,
and awake, singing, it all will come out fine. I've learned it line by line. One common wire, one silver thread, all that you desire rolls on ahead.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've learned so much about climate change from my daughter Jessie and Rebecca, through working a bit with Pathway to Paris, and I've written this poem, which I can't see unless I put my glasses on. Sorry. Supplication to nature. If we be blind, if we turn away from nature, garden of the soul, she will turn on us. In place of songbird, the shrill cry of the locust devouring the harvest, the terrible crackling of the blazing rainforest, the peatland smoldering, the seas rising, cathedrals flooding, the Arctic shelf melting, the Siberian wood burning, the barrier reef bleached as the bones of forgotten saints. If we be blind, failing in our supplication to nature, species will die, the bee and the butterfly driven to extinction. All of nature, nothing more than an empty husk, the unholy ghost of an abandoned hive. Hard to clap for that one.
Yeah.
So the third to do is a poem, a beautiful poem that also had to, of a poet who had to view destruction around him, but was still captivated by the promise and the hope of spring. And it was written by the young Dylan Thomas during war. Holy spring. Bed of love, when that immortal hospital made one more move to soothe the curlous, counted body and ruin and its causes. Over the barbed and shooting sea, assumed an army, swept into our wombs and houses. I climb to greet the war in which I have no heart, but only that dark, only that dark, that one dark. I owe my light. Call for confessor and wiser mirror. There is none. glow after the gods' stoning night. And I am struck, as lonely as a holy marker, by the sun. No. No praise. Praise that the springtime is all. Gabriel and radiant shrubbery as the morning grows joyful. Out of the woe-begone pyre and the multitude's sultry tear turns cool on the weeping well. My arising prodigal, son the father, his quiver full of the infants of pure fire. But blessed be hail and upheaval that uncalm still it is sure alone to stand and sing. Alone in the husk of man's home, and the mother and toppling house of the holy spring, if only for one last time. Dylan Thomas.
Happy birthday, Patti.
Thank you. Thank you, teacher. Thank you.